Now that we have a better understanding for how things can be grouped together to communicate relationships, let's talk about the specifics of laying things out on the screen. Material design uses an 8-dip grid to align components. Text aligns to a 4-dip baseline grid. Let's take a closer look at the grid so you can see it a bit clearer. Notice that for finer grain control, the baselines of text sit on a 4-dip grid. That's kind of a subset of this 8-dip grid. So things like image and icon sizes, spacing, margins, and paddings are all multiples of 8-dip. So things like 16, 72, 40, and 16, those are multiples of 8. And for text, line heights are multiples of 4, so 20-dip. These 8-dip and 4-dip grids allow us to easily apply the laws of grouping and keep our UIs organized, balanced, and in harmony with the rest of the operating system. There are material design templates and stencils that use this grid, available for Adobe Illustrator, Photoshop, and Sketch. Check the instructor's notes for links to them. Even though there's a grid, we need a couple other pieces to lay out our UIs. Keylines are used to vertically or horizontally align objects in a user interface. Aesthetically, they enforce a sense of order in a UI. They also make it much quicker to scan the screen and take in the information. The material design spec suggests some common keylines to use in mobile design, using 16-dip margins from the left and right for auxiliary content like icons and avatars and so on, and 72 dips from the left edge for the primary content, the things like the page title and the page contents. Now, if you don't have auxiliary content, then your primary content should probably also align to the 16-dip keyline. And the exact value of these keylines is less important than the concept. Aligning content to bring order to your UI and making it quicker to visually parse. Before we move further, let me pass it over to James to have you apply these concepts in Android Studio.